Hi friends! In today's video, we'll go over how to make donut charts in Figma. But before you continue watching, please keep in mind that there are plugins out there that can quickly generate a chart if you need one as soon as possible. So there are plugins such as Charts or Chart. However, if you do want to learn how to make this from scratch, as well as learn like technical nuances and some UX tips, then this video is definitely for you. So we're going to begin in an empty Figma file. The first thing that I'm going to do is I'll create an ellipse. We'll also make it bigger. Now when you hover over it, you'll see this dot appears. You're going to click it and then you're going to drag it. So this ellipse is going to be our first segment. And then the second thing that we need to do is that we're going to adjust our ratio. So if you were making a pie chart, you can just leave it like this. But if you want to have a donut chart, you will click this dot and then drag it. You can also use the property panel. Like if you don't want this decimal numbers, you can use that to adjust. The last thing is that I want to soften up the corners of this segment. So I'm going to give this a corner radius of 4. So this was our first segment. And when you're making a pie or a donut chart, the segments should be sorted with the highest value starting in the 12 o'clock position, followed by each smaller segment going in the clockwise direction. So what I'm going to do is, since this will most likely be the largest segment, I want to adjust it so that it starts right here at the 12 o'clock position. And to do that, I'm going to hover over this start dot, and then I can just move it. And the reason you want to drag the start dot instead of just rotating the shape is because if I were to just rotate the shape, you can see that now my whole layer is rotated and it doesn't look neat with this edges as opposed to here. I still have this nice even square, which makes it easier when you're working with a bunch of different layers around this pie chart and when you're rearranging and moving stuff around. Now let's make two more segments for our donut chart. And by the way, ideally, you should not have more than 5 segments so that it's easier to understand your chart. So what I'm going to do is just copy and paste the second segment. And I'll use the sweep to make it smaller. And then we'll copy paste again. Move the start position. And use the sweep to make it smaller. Now I'm going to rename this to segment, and I'm going to group everything together and call it chart. And now that we have our chart, we'll want to add some colors to it. And colors for charts can get really tricky because you want anyone to be able to easily distinguish them no matter how they view the world. And of course, this gets even trickier if you have a palette, like a brand palette that you have to stick to, and the colors of which may not be accessible right out of the box. If you don't have a palette that you have to stick to, one thing that you can do is go to this tool, which I will link down below. You can select the number of colors that you need and then click generate. And the tool is going to suggest you accessible colors that you can use. If you don't like these colors for some reason, you can click generate again and it's going to come up with something else. You can also filter down your results, like if you wanted something like within this color range, or if you want to modify lightness, or if there is a specific color that you want to use, you can add it here. And then once again, you're going to click generate and it's going to give you a new set of colors. If you do have a specific palette that you have to stick to, the first thing you can do is to use this tool, input your colors, and then go through these categories to see if there are any potential conflicts. Ideally, you want as little conflicts as possible. And if you find that your colors don't work together well at all, one thing you can do is take your set and you're going to return to our very first tool. And then you're going to add your colors right here. And you want to make sure that no other filters are selected. Click generate. And yes, your colors might be slightly different from your initial input, but they'll still resemble your initial set. Most importantly, of course, they'll be more accessible. And a good practice overall is to have a set of specifically designated chart colors in your color set, which you can use every time you need a chart so that you don't have to spend time doing this over and over again. So these are the colors that I initially chose for my donut chart. What I'm going to do now is turn them into color styles. And I'm going to apply them to my donut chart. While it's necessary to make sure that your colors are accessible, we shouldn't rely on color alone. And the more colors you have, the harder it is to make sure that they all are always distinguishable from each other. We can enhance our segment styles by adding a pattern to them. For example, I'm going to create a frame, an ellipse, maybe make it smaller, then remove the fill from my frame. Let's call it like pattern. And I'll make the circle black. Now I'm going to copy it over a couple times. Group it. Let's call it pattern one. Export it. And now we're going to update our color styles. We're going to add another fill. And this fill is going to be an image fill. And the image is going to be our new pattern. After you add the pattern, you'll see that it appears really big. What I'm going to do is change it from fill to tile and decrease the percentage. And you can really play around with how big you want the circles to be. So then the next thing that we're going to do is repeat that two more times by creating different patterns for the remaining two styles. So for this next one, I'm just going to do simple boxes. Call it pattern two. And then we'll add a fill. So now we have our second pattern. And then for a last one, I'm making just a simple line. I did make it thicker so that it's more distinguishable from the boxes one. And because it is going to be on this darker color, maybe I'll make it white instead of black. And now I'm going to export it. And we'll add the image fill, change it to tile, and decrease the opacity so it doesn't jump out that much. And that's about it for the chart itself. So you don't have to keep these patterns, you can just get rid of them. One last thing that I want to mention are labels. So the reason I had to make a donut chart was for a presentation, which means that it was not an interactive donut chart. So I could get away with just having a simple label, like having my legend title here, and then having a category, and then having like a label for each segment. But of course, if you are designing a donut or pie chart for an app, you should also think about interactivity, like how can you display labels when you're hovering over each segment, as well as which library your developers are going to use to implement this chart, because often that can influence design decisions and what's going to be feasible. By the way, I'm also going to link down below this very useful page about designing donut charts by the Spectrum Design System. It has a lot of do and don'ts examples. And a lot of the information that I shared in this tutorial came directly from this page. And on the very last note, I'm not an accessibility expert. So if you have some feedback about stuff that I mentioned here, any corrections, anything that I'm missing, please let me know. Thank you for watching, and until next time, bye-bye.